Welcome to the class 10 social science subject, and today we are going to start a fresh new lesson, our first lesson of history. Before I'm going to start a lesson today, I just wanted to wish you all the very best to you all, because you have entered your very important stage in your life, 10th standard, and you are unable to come to the school because of this COVID-19. Otherwise you would have entered the school by this Zoom and you would have enjoyed your learning process. And this COVID-19 should not be a barricade of our life. So learning process should not be stopped, and learning process should be keep continuing every day. That's why we have started online classes to give you the best, and learning process and teacher and students contact should be always there. That we have to show to the world. So we have started this online classes. So that's what this life is very, very important, your 10th standard life. So keep learning, keep some of your time reserved for your study, learning process, and keep studying, learn properly, then you will be successful in your life. All the best. So we are going to start first lesson, the rise of nationalism in Europe. And you already know what is nationalism. And you already know what is Europe. Europe is a continent. And nationalism. So how we have felt? We can feel a country, a nationality. So we are belongs to this country. We have a equality and a freedom and integrity. We have all the rights to live here. And we can enjoy that nationalism in the freedom countries and independent countries. Same way, how can we feel a continent freedom? Continental nationalism in Europe. Europe is a continent. We cannot feel easily, because we are unable to feel Asian continent. We are not the Asian continent people. We cannot feel, but how we are going to study today about nationalism in Europe means that Europe countries, though which all countries will come under the Europe continent, like France, Italy, Belgium, and all, we just take each part of the country. And every countries, and how the nationalism rise in every countries, how it become independent, how the people of their countries got independence, equality, and all that we are going to study today. And now rise means how every country means in continent means in country only the system means how the European countries have started rising the nationalism in particular places. That we are going to start. Means this is the introductionary part. Today we are going to complete the study about introductionary part. See, when did this happen? It all happened in the 19th century. You know about century, I hope so. 19th century means 1800 to 1900. That between that time is called 19th century. So during 19th century, who rise the voice for nationalism in the Europe continent, and which country started, and how it is started, why it is started, that we have to study. And see, nationalism. Nationalism means what? Nation states. Nation states means what? Means people of their country, they should get equal opportunity, equality in the society, all the freedom, rights to live, and their opinion to run the country means for all the kind of government has to be involved with the people. That is called nation state. So when the people of their country started rising the voice for the nationalism, so when we get the result, when we rise the voice for the nationalism, we get the result of nation state. Nation state we get. Okay, what was there before nation state? When we raised the voice for the nationalism, what was there before that? Before that, multinational dynasty were there. Multinational dynastic ruling was there. What is it? It means kings were ruling the countries. Means in country, different kind of the parts was ruling by the kings. Means king, many. Means multinational means many dynasty, multi. Dynasty were there. Multi dynasty, what happens? See, that one dynasty will be ruled by a king. Now, king will be decided what is going to happen, what has to be done, what is the rules and regulations, what is how the people has to live, what is the service the king has to give to the dynasty. So means when multi dynasties were there, multi kings will be there. When multi kings will be there, the different king will different type of ruling will be there. So different type of a custom, different kind of a living style, different kind of a taxes, different kind of a communication, different kind of languages will be there, different kind of many things will be there. Means all the dynasty will be not same. So because of that, so everyone will not be treated equally. Then that's what that is also for modern state. Modern state means completely centralized power. Completely centralized power will be owned by a ruler, a king. So that has to go. Means people has to decide. People should get some of their rights. So that when it comes, that is what nation state means. The ruler also should think of people. The people also involved in the administrative system. But what is the nation state means? I can give you an example of the features of nation state. What is that? See, first and foremost thing is sense of common identity. Means whole country people should be having the same sense of identity. What identity should be? I am belongs to this country. For example, I think I am an Indian. You are an Indian. He is an Indian. She is an Indian. That sense of common identity. Because when it comes a nation in the nation state. If it is a dynastic ruling, so they cannot say one place name because a different kind of a dynasty will be there. So one state will be there in the nation state. That is sense of common identity. We all are belongs to one identity and one language, one flag will be there, one method of ruling will be there, one method of paying taxes will be there, and this is called a sense of common identity. And the second one is shared history. We can share our history. The same history will be there for the whole country. And if it is a dynasty, different kind of a dynasty will be there, different kind of a shared history will be there. Because that family ruler will be different, and the next upcoming ruler will be a same family person. And this dynastic person, his ruler will be a different person, and his upcoming ruler will be one who is going to ascend the throne will be from his family. And then this and one dynasty people will just announce the war on another dynasty. That will happen. So it is one nation, a nation state. So one language, one state, one language, one type of attacks, the same living style will be there, same shared history will be there. Struggle also to build a nation. Only one type of struggle will be there. Whole Indian people will be there, the one who fought for the to build a nation state. They all will be saying, yes, we have struggled. Our forefathers struggled for Indian independence. Your forefathers also struggled for Indian independence. Means to build that nation, whole country people, for whatever they struggle, that is for nation. If this struggle will be in the dynastic ruling, it will be different. Because their struggling will be different, these people's struggling will be different. So, see how the features of nation state will be there, sense of common identity will be there, and shared history will be same, and struggle will be same, because this all will be for nation state. So, this is how people started fighting for nationalism in the Europe. In the Europe continent, some of the countries people started fighting for and arising voice for nationalism. Understood? I hope you understood about the rise of nationalism in Europe. This is completely introductory part. So, the which country started the first and very important nationalism struggle or nationalism voice, where it is lying exactly, let us study in the tomorrow's class. Thank you so much.